Welcome to Holy Week at St. Pius X, where we enter into the heart of our faith. My name is Cami Engel, and on behalf of Father Walsh, Deacon Marty, and our parish community, we want to thank you for joining us as we celebrate the Mass of the Lord's Supper on this Holy Thursday. Jesus shared the Passover meal with his disciples and washed their feet on the night before he was crucified. Let us pray together today that we may imitate Christ's love for us by serving our neighbors with the same spirit of humility, generosity, and faithfulness. Please stand.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the
Welcome the holy oils into our parish. These oils, used for the administration of the sacraments, bring healing, peace, and holy joy. We praise and thank our God for the gifts of the sacraments, which these oils symbolize. We thank our bishop for the blessing for blessing them for our use. Oil of the sick. This oil of the sick has been blessed by our bishop for the healing of body, mind, and soul. May the sick who are anointed with it experience the compassion of Christ and his saving love. Oil of the catechumens. This oil of the catechumens has been blessed by our bishop for the anointing of those preparing for baptism. Through this anointing, they are strengthened by Christ to resist the power of Satan and reject evil in all its forms as they prepare for the saving waters of baptism. Holy Chrism. This holy chrism, a mixture of olive oil and perfume, has been consecrated by our bishop and the priests of the diocese. It will be used to anoint infants after baptism, those who are confirmed, bishops and priests at their ordination, and altars and churches at the time of their dedication.
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son went about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the Church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love. Grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If the family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share in the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a one-year-old male and without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month, and then, with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it: with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand, you shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on the same night, I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, which all your generations shall celebrate with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosened my bonds. Offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people.
Our blessing cup is our communion with the blood of Christ.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, also the cup, after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he comes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Before the feast of Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with a towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What I am doing you do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." And Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then not only my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over." So you are clean, but not all. For he knew he would be betrayed, and for this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do. My sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Can you imagine if we all left here this evening, went home, and in our backyards slaughtered a goat or a lamb, and then took its blood and threw it on the lintel of the door, and the two doorposts, in hopes that evil spirits would stay away from us? That's what the pagans believed in early times. But this time, it was different. The Israelites have been told by God to do this. So as the angel of death passed over their homes, they would be spared and survive. So smearing of the blood of lambs was nothing new to them. And they were not superstitious, but they understood the word of God. That blood reminded them that God would guide them as they passed over from slavery to freedom. And to this day, Jewish people eat the Passover meal to express their faith that God continues to be with them on their life's journeys. That journey as they pass, just like us, from life to death. At the Last Supper, Jesus gave new meaning to the Passover meal, though. And he was painfully aware, make no mistake about it, that his life was about to come to an end. Aware that he himself was about to pass over from this world to life with his Father into eternity. He told his disciples that a new exodus was at hand. This time, he was to be the lamb whose blood would be spilled. And through his blood, he was to accomplish a new deliverance for his people, a deliverance from sin and death. And like Jesus, each of us is a part of that process of passing over from life to death to eternity with the Heavenly Father. And like Jesus, we face so many Passovers in our lives. We go from sickness to health, from brokenness to wholeness, hatred to love, disunity to unity, and from guilt to forgiveness. Passing over is a part of the human experience, and we can never escape it. But instead of going home this evening and smearing blood on the doorposts to ward off frightening spirits, we have begun the Paschal Triduum. We enter into this solemn observance, not as a group of dramatic actors or actresses intent on what would happen to Jesus, for that happened only once in history and cannot be repeated. But rather, we enter into these days trusting that the scripture readings, the ritual actions, and the quiet prayer and fasting will have the power to make the Lord's Passover in the ways we pass over in our daily lives. It is most appropriate, then, that we begin these days in celebration of the Eucharist, that special, very special Passover moment given by Jesus to strengthen all of us in our many Passovers. Fed by the Word of God and the Lord's body and blood. We know we cannot stand still during life's Passover moments when we do this. Fed by the Word and Sacrament, we can best face those moments by putting ourselves at the humble service of other people. That's the example Christ set by washing the feet of his disciples. Because as we are busy taking care of others, washing their feet, mending their wounds, or simply just being in their presence, we heal them. We give them a sense of peace. They do the same for us. Because at that point, we're no longer afraid of that mini Passover that seems to threaten our security and our well-being. And God leads us through these moments because God has literally marked us by the blood of the Lamb, ensuring that we also walk through those Passovers just as Christ the Lamb sacrificed for all of us.
Under normal circumstances, we'd have the washing of the feet, reenacting what Jesus did for his disciples, but with the whole COVID, the diocese asked us not to do that, and smartly so. So we're going to pass on that. So why don't we stand? We'll go right to our prayer of the faithful. And tonight, as we begin our three-day celebration of our redemption, we approach our saving God with the needs of our world.
For the church, that we may live like Jesus and spend our lives in loving service, washing the feet, carrying the burdens, and comforting the brokenness of one another.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For all priests, those who have answered the call, and those considering a vocation to the priesthood, that they may be strengthened and renewed by God's love, and keep open the hearts of those who are discerning.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who cannot eat at the table of the Lord, that our love, friendship, and service may offer them an experience of God's love, a sense of community, and support for life's journeys.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gift of peace, that God will bring an end to COVID-19 and all the suffering around the world, especially among our most vulnerable, the poor, the many displaced and living in refugee camps, third world countries, and people already devastated by war and terrorism.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, those approaching death, particularly those with COVID-19, and all the intentions in our parish intercessory prayer book, that God will ease their pain and send an angel to comfort and strengthen them.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are grieving the death of a loved one, that God will comfort them, draw them close in love, and grant them peace.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For those prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts.
Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
And Heavenly Father, you always have at heart the salvation of your people. Hear our prayers and the needs they represent, and answer them as you will. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks, O Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with the angels and archangels, thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all that you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. And therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these sacred mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving you thanks, said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And in song, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord, until you come again.
And therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, in recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Pius X and all the saints, on whose constant intercession, your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, the order of bishops and all the clergy and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. And Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. And the peace of the Lord with you always.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Precious body, precious blood, here in bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares the feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Precious body, precious blood, here in bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares the feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Precious body, precious blood, here in bread and wine. Here the Lord prepares the feast divine. Bread of love is broken now, cup of life is poured. Eat this bread. the spotless Virgin, born for us on earth below. He has been with us conversing, stayed the seeds of truth to sow. Then he closed in solemn majesty. Stay.